As God takes the initiative and moves towards us, we take the initiative moving toward others. In your life as a Christian, it's likely that there will have been a person, or perhaps many people, who will have had a great influence on your life by moving towards you in a way that helped reveal more of the love of God to you. Imagine that you're completely broke and in heavy debt, and that you hear a knock at your front door. And when you open the front door, the Queen of England is standing there. And she's not standing there with a great entourage. She hasn't got a big expensive car there. No, she's bruised and muddy. She's been walking through fields and crossing rivers to get to you. And when she gets there, she tells you, "I'm committed to you. I want to pay off your debts. I want to set you up for life." Now that is a ridiculous thought. But at Christmas, we celebrate that our God, our King Jesus, became Emmanuel. This incredible phenomenon that the Creator God stepped into his creation. The author stepped into his book. The artist stepped into his painting. Why? To pursue mankind and to rescue. This is what God is like at heart. He goes after those that he has set his love upon. As Jesus said, he came to seek and save that which was lost. Ed Welch teaches us this lesson using Ezekiel 34:11, which says, "For thus says the Lord God, behold, I myself will search for my sheep and will seek them out." These sheep were people who had walked away from God. They were sufferers and they were sinners. They were certainly not intending on moving toward God. His mercy and his compassion made the move towards them. There are many accounts in the Bible of God taking the initiative, especially towards those in need, even when it was just for one person. Each and every one of those accounts is a story of grace. He pursues people like you and me, not because we're impressive or even because we took a step towards him. No, we were simply sick and needed him. In fact, it's worse. We were enemies who had no intention to surrender. God's love for us is not determined on us. It's his character and it's his decision to love us, even when our response is often selfish, indifferent, or pathetic. He loves in the face of resistance. This is genuine, one-way love, and it gives us an idea of why it can be hard for us to move towards others. The one taking the initiative in the relationship, the one who loves most, is the one who risks humiliation. But what if we let Jesus reach our hearts with his love? What if we truly believe and receive his love for us, letting go of lies and letting go of fear that he doesn't care? What if you stand confident in his acceptance and his cherishing of you, and it starts to change the way you see others? You no longer migrate to your closest friends or the easiest people in the room, but you start to move towards the needy, the quiet, and the forgotten. Our aim in this is to create a culture where people are quick to move toward each other, active more than passive, loving more than waiting to be loved. This is an aspect of what Paul means when he calls us to put on Christ. This kind of culture runs to the sound of the guns. When we hear of trouble, we don't shrink back. We're not silent. We lean in and we move towards the need. As we move towards others, we need humility and help from Scripture to help us navigate with sensitivity and wisdom. Ed Welch gives us some helpful guidance. First, the Lord calls us family, so we greet warmly. Second, the Lord knows our name, so we learn people's names. And third, the Lord knows details about us, like the number of hairs on our heads, so we take interest in the details of the lives of others. It's only when we move towards others warmly, taking genuine interest, that we will know them well enough to be able to care for them well. And as people tell us of good news, hardships, growth, and even sin, we take time to listen. We give careful attention, not half-hearted, impatient, or distracted attention. This is where we begin to share the burdens and the delights. The aim in moving towards others is to be people of understanding. Being properly understood is probably one of the greatest desires that people have. We've received this kind of love ourselves. As God takes the initiative and moves towards us, we take the initiative moving towards others.